was so smart then, in your jacket and...
Originally I wanted to be a writer, and I especially wanted to write children's stories. But I couldn't, I just can't spell and I can't write, so, I mean, it was no good.
Dad had taken the time to teach me guitar and gave me a real passion for guitar that I didn't quite realise until I got out into the big wide world that was actually quite a big gift he'd given me.
I'd been writing songs for as long as I can remember, you know. It wasn't till I began playing them to my dad that I realised that, you know, I could do something with them if I worked on them.
I guess when we all started, we didn't have much to do, so we put on our own gigs and play together. And that was really fun, and that was very much a community.
The community aspect of the music we play is wonderful, but I also think it's even more wonderful when applied to general community. Things are much nicer when you feel part of something.
When I'm in America or Australia, I really egg up the English, just sort of, I don't know why. It's not on purpose, just when I'm on stage, I've got a completely different speaking voice to what I do when I'm at home. But that's because I feel, I feel hopelessly English sometimes. I'm usually thinking about home when I'm on stage, so maybe that's it. England, I don't know really. I wonder whether it's more that because I'm away so much, I just miss it. Just because I feel very English. And actually, I suppose that's quite a rare thing these days to feel very, especially in England where it's, you know, a bit iffy if you're really patriotic, whereas in America, you know, American flags all over the shop.
My husband left me last night. Left me a poor and lonely wife.
Trying to think about my role as an entertainer and whether I can separate myself as an entertainer just as a human being.
Any musician who can play and wants to play with people is part of our community, you know. It's never exclusive at all, and I think it's the same here, you know, that everyone keeps saying, you know, that you've got to come to Rajasthan and you can meet all the different musicians and you can choose who you want to play with and play with different people every day. And that's what's good about music, I think, making people feel part of something, even if it's only for a song. I think the basis of it that we all love, like all of us guys love sitting down and playing with each other. But it's more that we like playing each other's songs rather than traditional songs. What stuck out to me is the fact that we're all called folk musicians in England. And it's just such a bollocks. I mean, we're not folk musicians. They each were taught their instruments by their respective parents. And the songs are all old songs passed down orally. That's what folk music is. And it's not a genre. It's just the way that it's learned.
I might be a part of this, a ripple on water from a lonesome drip, a fallen tree that witnessed me, him alone, him and me. All of this can be broken, all of this can be broken. Hold your devil by your spoke and spin him to the ground.
I'm never ungrateful for anything that I do. because all of it's an incredible experience, but it was an experience unlike... It was different to what I expected it to be. Yeah, I lost my patience a few times. I've never experienced anything like that last gig in Calcutta. I don't write songs that people can dance to, or... I wouldn't write songs if I didn't want people to listen to them.
Hello.
Yeah.
My name's Zora. And we've been in India for 2 weeks. And this is... Oh, yeah. This is the biggest gig we've done so far. So rock and roll, folk and roll.
Apart from the 5 expats at the front, nobody else wanted us to be there. But you know, like, it was our last gig and I just felt like I'm not going to be defeated by this. So well, I only played 4 songs, but I screamed them.
Sing it to me if we are to battle, I must not.
If you put it in that horrible way, an entertainer, that's basically all I am. So, then that's what I had to be in India. I had to just play the songs and try and make people like them or make sure people are having a good time. And I'd never really thought of the craft of being an entertainer like that before.
Street, staring solely at his feet, clutching pictures of past lovers at his side. Stood at the table where she sat and removed his hat in respect of her presence.
Yeah, I think touring has really... It's, the time that we live in now, it's become very important because it's, you know, not to bang on or moan or anything, but it's the last thing that the artist owns now.
Unlock the lock that kept it dark, and read a written warning, sing I'm still mourning.
I find it very fulfilling. I find writing songs very normal. I find the studio very abnormal. And I find touring very fulfilling because it's a challenge. There's such a lovely feeling in the room for me being up there and performing. It's so amazing. I still can't quite believe it. It takes a gig to remind me just how bizarre it is. Wonderful.
Faulty or knees, it's not like I believe in ever.
The community of music doesn't just extend to the people that we're playing with, it's the people that we're playing to. And so the more we play live, the more, you know, we get used to playing live. And the more people who keep coming back, that is what makes it so exciting. And that's, I guess, what I learned from playing with Neil Young, is that these people have probably been coming to see Neil Young for 30 years, you know. And there's still 10,000 of them in each town, in England. That's exciting.
The ghost that broke his heart, oh, the ghost that broke my heart. The ghost, the ghost, the ghost, the ghost, the ghost, the ghost, the ghost that broke my heart before I met you.
The third album has been sort of half written, half thrown away, you know, that classic two minds kind of thing. I wouldn't want to just put out an album that's got one good song on it, which I think could become very easy. You could become very complacent, I'm sure. I would like to do the third album in the same way we did the second album, like recording in a room all together to tape. There's lots of factors that make it sound the way it did sound. And you can change the arrangements, but it'll still have that core sound. And maybe one day I'll branch out and I'll make a completely different style of album, but I think for now, stylistically, it's not that different. You know, it's not techno or jazz or anything like that. So, if it ain't broke, kind of thing.
fall to your knees.